just, okay, let me check this thing is, okay, it's already pressurized. Okay, so here goes nothing. Okay, so things are falling. Okay. Okay, so as you noticed, when it was extending, it was faster compared to when it was retracting. The reason being, this restrictor here is restricting the air only one instance. That's when it was retracting, right? So if you exchange this from this side and put it the other side, you see that our cylinder will behave differently. The reason being that it's now restricting air that is trying to be exhausted. Well, let me try to do this. Okay, today I'm kind of alone, so it's kind of okay. It's just a pain. Okay, I want to, okay, to screw this thing in. Keeps doing that. Okay, I think I'm about to give up. Okay, fine. But here's the thing, without the restrictor, both sides, I want you to check the behavior of the cylinder. So you can tell here that the cylinder is retracting and extending at the same speed because we've removed the restrictor here. But with the restrictor in, let me try once more. Okay, I think we've just succeeded. Don't give up. Such is with Africa. Don't give up. Keep trying. Though you keep hitting holes, don't give up. That's what they tell us. Okay, now with the restrictor in, check the behavior. So clearly you can tell now that it's way slower when it extends than when it retracts, simply by shifting this restrictor here. Okay guys, that's about it for now. As you can see, I'm struggling alone here. Watch out for part 2, where I'll be showing you how to calculate the amount of force that this can produce at a given amount of pressure. With this compressor here, it can go up to about 8 bars. So basically we'll be calculating using that, and also how this valve works in detail, how it redirects air and everything. So watch out for part 2. I'll probably be filming that with some help. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe.